praise and adoration. As we celebrate the precious gift of faith and our belief in the risen Lord. So join us in this time of prayer and song before our blessed Lord.
We begin tonight, we ask for the intercession of our blessed Mother. We continue to seek her protection. We continue to seek her intercession. We ask Mother Mary to wrap us in the mantle of love and protection. And in this wonderful Easter season,
Yeah. According to Luke, the disciples of Jesus recounted what had taken place along the way and how they had come to recognize him in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, Jesus' words to his disciples have always been extraordinarily meaningful for me. Jesus doesn't just create peace. He doesn't only create an atmosphere of peace, as he does here with us. He offers his peace, just as we do often at the beginning of Mass, or before the reception of communion, the Lord offers his peace. It's an invitation that we do not have to accept. But like salvation, it is something that we can reject. The peace that Christ offers you, do not reject it. We also have to recognize the context of this gospel passage and the sort of peace that Jesus offers. It's not the same sort of peace that one possesses who is simply Zen or someone who has achieved some mental indifference or some stoicism, not being shaken one way or another. Jesus redeems mind, body, and soul in his resurrection. Because of all of these faculties, in all of them, mankind longs for peace. Jesus undergoes the deepest torments imaginable in his life. Doubt, anguish, loneliness, isolation, abandonment, and of course, what we see the most often, physical pain, so that he can redeem all of these that we would undergo. Brothers and sisters, if Jesus did not experience it, he could not redeem it. So if Jesus for you is simply an ideal, or it matters more to you that one is simply a good person, recognize this. There are no real answers without Christ, only coping mechanisms. There are no real answers without Christ, only coping mechanisms. Finally, the Lord Jesus extends his peace, and it is only to be found in the presence of the risen Lord. Brothers and sisters, it's by the great providence of God, by the fact that he provides, that we, the church's ministers, and you at home find yourself in the presence of the risen Lord. And he extends his peace to us, even and most especially in the most difficult of situations. Will you accept the peace that Jesus has made ready and extended to you this Easter? Or will you deny it in favor of anxiety or worry? Jesus helps us to experience his peace when he says, "Look at my hands and my feet. Risen, but still bearing those marks, because they are for us marks of love. Love for us. Peace be with you."
Thank you.
Lord Jesus, we just sit in grateful awe of you, our risen Lord. Your nature is such a gift, in totality, a total self-gift to us. In so much as the only thing you left empty was the tomb, the grave. So fill us tonight. Fill us with yourself. Fill us with your love, with your mercy, with your grace. Because you alone are who we adore. You alone are who we worship. You alone are God.